actual pronunciation of your name?
George.
Yeah, and Gastaldi. Gastaldi and Benevides.
Yep.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Building HTTP server.
Wow, crowded room.
So, we can start. Hello, everybody. Let me introduce the next two speakers. One is Rafael Benevides, and second is George Gastaldi. They will be talking more about Java Enterprise Edition 7 with JBoss Forge.
Yeah.
Encourage you to ask questions. You can get some awesome prizes. Guys also have one special one, I believe, but they will tell you. Also, please give us feedback about the conference on Twitter. Write a blog article and stuff. I would like to also remind you on Sunday there will be contest for awesome prizes like YubiKeys, some Raspberry Pis, I believe, and stuff. And that's it.
All right. Thank you very much. So, who works with JavaEE in here? Okay. Do you guys know JBoss Forge? No, nothing at all. Oh, we have one. Okay. Well, I'm the JBoss Forge project lead. This is Rafael Benevides. He's helping me with the lab, and I have prepared for you a special script, a special document explaining what JBoss Forge is and what should you do to run it and create JavaEE applications. So I have provided the instructions over here. This is the HTML version, this is the PDF version if you want to download to your machine and read it. So if you install JBoss Developer Studio, you will be able to follow these instructions in a very smooth way. Oops, let me open the browser. Did anyone attend the talk about Wildfly Swarm yesterday? Okay. In the end of the talk, we had a special request saying that if anyone could change the project that we created to support Keycloak, we would give an award. Did anyone do that? No?
No, we have to find a new challenge.
All right, we need a new challenge. We have a Raspberry Pi to present for, we need to decide. Maybe the first one who ends this. These instructions would be the winner. Basically, what we want to achieve in this lab is, let me open it. If you access the HTML version, this will be the... Oh, do I have internet?
I don't think so.
Use the network cable, because that should...
Hang on.
Yeah, the Wi-Fi is useless.
Where is that network cable?
It should be in the bottom of the
page.
Yeah, there's...
It's here, maybe.
Yeah.
Why?
No worries.
Okay.
It's already... So, this is the hands-on lab that it was initially used in the... I think it was in Java one, or DevOps, I'm not sure exactly, but...
Even in Ivano, okay.
Yeah, so we have some contributors. I just add my name as the last one as I updated to the latest Forge features. And you will find in this document everything you need to get started with Forge. Forge itself, it's a, like we like to say, it's a red tool, use it to develop applications. And it has a tight integration with the IDEs, with the major IDEs, like Eclipse, IntelliJ IDE, NetBeans, and even provides a command line interface for those who prefer to work on the CLI without any IDE. So what you can find in this document is some steps on how to create the project. We have support for NetBeans and also web that we're not showing in this lab, but anyway, Forge supports it. What IDE do you use mostly? Do you use Eclipse or what do you use?
Yeah, I most of my use Eclipse and NetBeans.
NetBeans, okay. Okay, if you want, instead of installing Developer Studio, you could you can download the JBoss Forge plugin for NetBeans that is available on the NetBeans website. And you can follow the same instructions for the graphical part. Typically, when we create a project with the JBoss Forge, this will be the graphical display when using NetBeans. And well, if you follow the pictures, I think it would be much easier.
That's your version of JBoss.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
I have provided with Rafael the latest JBDS version. It's 9.1.0 beta 2, which bundles the latest Forge version, which is the recommended version for this lab. And
let me try to.
It's available on the network.
Yeah, it's almost available because I'm still having issues with the network.
For the Wi-Fi, it helps if you keep the tap open because it's some weird, router login, and at least this will work for me. Thank you.
Okay, so let me see here.
Do we have Fabiano Gibson USB sticks?
Yeah, of course. No, these are two distributions containing the materials.
Okay. We might have the JBoss Developer Studio here.
Shall I distribute them?
Let me just check if it's really here. Oh, just
open.
Oh, sure.
Yes.
Okay, sorry.
Some of them aren't working, so.
Oh, good to know.
That helps. Yeah, like we try to eliminate them. It can happen. Do you find new one?
Okay. There it is. Oh, this is the 9.0.
Okay, so.
Yeah, and this is it's not updated. Oh, dear God. Yeah, this is an old version. This is not the correct version. Let me put it here. And go like this.
Probably will be faster than.
Yeah. Need the installation, but I can try.
I can download here. It's faster.
Yeah, so this lab is suited for the Forge 3, which is on beta 4. It has some differences between the Forge 2. The main difference is that it's compiled against JDK 8 and it has support for stacks, which it's described in the document here as another field for the project new. And also, there's there's a place where it's explained better. Oh, here, stack command option. We installed the JavaEE 7 dependencies. So, okay. If anyone wants the JBoss Developer Studio, the latest version I have here.
Is the Forge there as well?
Yes, Forge bundle is part of the JBoss Developer Studio.
You want to copy other other sticks and I can help them?
Yeah, I think it's easier.
Because I still building the image. Mm-hmm. I had to create because okay. The volume was full.
There's a workshops.
Is this ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Just let me place to build.
Okay. There is this USB stick coming from this from front to behind, and we'll do from behind to front, so we can meet in the middle.
There's another USB stick if you need it. If you have any question during the lab, please raise your hand.
No.
Okay. I'll be glad to help. Too late now. No problem, I can copy anyone.
Sebastian, is there another one with you? This seems not to be working.
Mm-hmm. All right. Give me a second.
Is there another issue? USB?
I'm creating another one.
Okay, let me see if I'm able to.
Does anyone else need a stick?
I'm on an old JBoss tools.
Yeah.
And I don't want to download it.
Is it working for you?
I
remember
using JBoss tools.
For my work?
Yeah.
Yes. I do a mix.
Is anyone here using IntelliJ right now? Using IntelliJ right now?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you have the JBoss Forge plugin installed?
In the previous version I had, but I'm now downloading the new version of IntelliJ idea.
Okay.
Shiny.
All right.
Once it's red. Do you need help?
Yeah, I'm just
waiting for me
to perform.
Finally, I was able to make it work. If you want to download from, I just created an HTTP server in my machine. For those that is still copying the files and want to get it from the local network instead of downloading from internet, you can go to this IP address. Is it clear from you that you are behind? And there is the JBoss Developer Studio 9.1 here, the JDK and Maven, whatever you need to be able to execute everything instead of downloading from the internet. And port 8082.
Oh, but it means I have a lot of
procedure,
and I still don't see. So this, in NetBeans, Forge will be enabled with this search box. So just type project.
Project.
Yeah, project should. It just take a while.
Because it's loading the
Forge. Yeah.
But after it gets
Yeah.
Okay, so it's working just like regular.
It's part of the
CLI.
Yeah, the fact is that the pure CLI is a bundle in only in the clips, but in the other IDEs you get the graphical stuff. So you can work, if you want to use CLI, you can download Forge from the website. It'll be a separate thing. You have the project new over there. I prefer the CLI, it's much faster than the graphical wizards, but anyway, it's a matter of taste, I guess.
If any of you have any doubts, just raise your hands and I'll be glad to help you. Do you have a USB there?
Takže to je nám prostě to rozbaleno?
Ne, fuj, je, to je to, je, to, je, to, je, to je nějaký musel, nějaký symbolický.
The link.
Maybe it's a Wi-Fi issue.
Yeah, Wi-Fi is not helping.
If you want to download from the website, you can type that small URL.
Nah, it's not gonna help either.
Let's help people. Do you want me to do in my machine because I'm connected in? I'm here. Do you want? Mm-hmm. So, what's the URL? Downloads.
Forge JBoss. But download. You know, enter. So, PO download.
Is it here?
Yeah, perfect. Click the button later to copy link address.
Yeah, vamos jogar lá no meet address. Forge lab, lab conf. Não quer alguma coisa?
Forge 300 beta 4.
Forge 300 beta 4, assim?
Isso.
Desse tamanhozão todo? O que tinha então?
Forge 3.
Beta,
Forge 3, só Forge 3 beta.
3 beta
4.
Melhor, né?
Fully. Forge 3.
Beta 4.
Forge.
Yep, é. É beta minúsculo.
A marcha passou na Angélica.
Porra, deve aceitar.
Yeah. If you want to download Forge, you can also use this URL,
which is
Forge 3 beta 4. This will download the zip file containing Forge if you want to use the command line version. If you don't like Eclipse, or
make it.
IDs.
Content folder.
No, thank you.
You're welcome.
Unfortunately, you won't have that IDE integration that Forge provides as an Eclipse.
Forge that allows you to execute the scripts. Actually, it's on this document, but you only learn at the end after you have done everything. And then you curse the guy who wrote that.
Oh, why didn't
you?
So smart.
This is USB sticks are really bad. I'm sorry about the sticks, USB sticks, they're not
helping.
They're supposed to help, but they're not.
Is there any other one?
Sounds a bit.
Thank you.
That's what I call luck.
Love it. I'm almost done.
Finished.
Good question. I don't know.
Really. Just the most. Does anyone need the sticker with the Forge installation and JBDS?
It's supposed to be the 3.0.
Okay.
I have 3.0.
Sounds
good. You're welcome.
Let's try.
At least I was able to help.
Here's the 3.0.
The
3.0, the Forge version.
The 3.0.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because on the stick there is the old version.
Yes.
And on the website I've been able to get the beta version as well.
I see that for JPA entities, there is equals according to the ID, primary key. You may not have assigned ID when you are doing something internally. It depends on, of course, on database server that you use. But is there any possibility how to change those?
Well, based on template, it's I think it's based on three markers templates.
Uh-huh. So I can change
no,
the template?
No, you could for the Forge project change the templates. Or maybe you can provide your own template.
Yeah, George should be the person to answer that question.
Okay.
Just a minute.
And what was your question? Regarding the execution of script.
Can you record it as well? I mean, if you are manually working like that, will you find somewhere from the history
I really don't know, because the way that I use is to execute and create a script, copy to the script, execute, copy to the script. So
what he says is would be a nice feature. You start a recording and all the
you don't have to copy. I mean, you type it once and you just go look and.
Excellent
something
idea.
Like start recording and stop recording and go to your script. So.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's
excellent
awesome.
Idea. This is what I call conference-driven development.
Okay.
I'll give this idea to George.
Yeah.
Because it's a nice one.
Okay, so that
like hashcode or equals that are based on ID, for example. Is it possible to change those? As it depends sometimes on the database provider whether it has ID already attached to the entity or doesn't.
The specific equals and hashcode is coded directly in Forge as a Forge plugin. The whole logic is on the Forge plugin, but you can create a command in Forge that does whatever you need. Like you could do your custom create equals hashcode command.
Okay, and is it possible to make an adapter for some existing command in JBoss Forge? You know, there is new entity command, and I know new entity with the right hash code and equals.
Okay. It's possible. There is a, it's still an undocumented feature, but it's there. You can add steps to any wizard that Forge already provides. Actually, I'm sorry, it is documented. Let me just show you. If you go to the Forge documentation, sorry, add-ons.
Cable.
Oh yeah, much better. Yes.
Much faster.
I think so. Better. Okay, so here in the UI, let me check here. Yeah, over here. Right, so, oh, damn it. Sorry. So, when you create a command, well, these are the steps to create a command, but in the same document, there are some features that the UI add-on provides. One of them, and one of the most interesting thing is this feature, is the navigation results transformer feature. Well, actually, when you are creating an add-on in Forge, all you need to do is to implement a certain interface, and then you can handle if the current command is a, for example, if it's the JK setup wizard, you can add your specific flow, your specific step into the end of the that navigation. So, what happens? If you install this plugin, install this add-on, what is defined in this step, in this wizard step, will appear in the last step of the JPA setup. So that's how you can increment,
customize
the existing functionality in Forge without creating new commands.
But if I want to remove previous step of the standard JPA setup, because you said that it's adding.
Yeah, we have the current flow here. You can actually return the navigation results with whatever you want.
Okay. So I can totally override.
Yeah, I'm preserving the current flow over here and adding a custom step.
Okay.
But you can just return your current step and.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's nice. By the way, he's
suggested a nice feature, which is record the comments to generate the Forge shell, the Forge script.
Oh, yeah, yeah, we have a Jira for that.
Oh, the Jira is already there.
Yeah, it's, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I remember. Actually, this is a, this is a very old feature. I haven't had time yet to work on it.
We have to clone you.
Yeah.
Something like that. They would start, say, start recording and do some file.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have this Jira. I'm sure of that. Forge history. I think it's logged at history. Not this.
Come on, history.
Oh, here. Forge 238.
Oh, it's very
it's closed.
In 2011?
Oh, yeah. I put that it's already done in Ash. I think I should probably reopen it. Well, actually, we do have a log file in the project. If you go to the your .forge/ash/history. There you can find all the history that you typed.
It's a pre-step.
Home folder?
Yeah, on the home folder, yeah. Did it work, Catherine?
It's working out.
Still downloading?
I ended up just killing the whole thing, setting it home. So now we're getting somewhere and we're not.
Download it on your machine because now it's your machine that's plugged. Let me get it. So, JDK.
You need the GDK?
Yeah.
I've got one.
The RPM.
For open JDK?
No, that's just the traditional.
I have like GDK 8 64 bits RPM.
Which one?
It doesn't say it from the
machine. Oh, I just have it here.
Yeah?
Just need another sticker. You stick? Not sticker.
Oh, there is something. There are some here.
was something difficult about the Gaussian.
Ne, ne, že to ten projekt ví, že mám jeden kompresor SATA, že to nastane jedna sedmička.
No, to je asi
now I can see it, but I tried it 4 times. I have never seen it before, so.
Maybe I give it a look.
Yeah.
It synchronizes the gear, but you can wish that it will work.
Sometimes just someone else have to come and see it.
Yeah,
that happens.
I was normally, but
it came over and worked.
Sometimes you're an awesome bot on a bug and you're asked at first. And but when they work, oh yeah, that's
good? Everything work?
Waiting for me.
Yeah, an evening.
On the pump valve, it's not even on the jar. It's stuck on the 3% of barrel.
Yesterday,
just take a look.
Okay.
kid and watching video from the kid.
Okay.
You're a multitask person.
See how it goes here. So do it. CD bookstore. With JavaEE 7. So yeah. Finish. And let me, the security,
yeah.
You're talking about this, right?
Yeah, yeah, because I just tried it and yeah, it's not adding.
The
what
constraint?
Was your issue yesterday? It was not closed, or? For me it was worse, it didn't add the security constraint.
Yeah,
it
I think that there's
the
a bug in the security constraint, but the add roll, it should work, the add roll.
Add roll, yeah, add roll, but it's the only one that works, I think. And the,
oh. And the, log-
oh, and
login.
The login methods. In which add-on?
It's on JavaEE.
JavaEE, of course.
Yeah. So, master.
Wow. You should do if you detect key club, you should open a new text file where you can paste the JSON content.
Oh, that would be cool.
And now it creates already the key club, the JSON file. Wow. I don't know if. If it must be a separate add-on.
We can provide an extension point in this command, so another add-ons could implement this extension point and or maybe use that navigation result transformer feature.
Oh yeah, yeah.
To provide an additional step.
Where
you can,
because that will be really smooth.
Wow, and that would be awesome. There's your homework.
No, there's an add-on build and install command, and that's it. It installs and it's already available for you to use. Did you create your own add-on?
No, yeah, I'm just trying for the
code.
Okay, Surreal, I installed that add-on, or that JBoss bug file add-on.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'm not able to set up server from I suppose application server.
Can you install it again?
Now it's doing something.
Yeah.
There is not any console output as I supposed to be.
There should be an output.
No, the IDE is totally
down.
But will work after a few minutes, I think, as it was the same before. But it would be nice to have an output from the task.
Better done in Eclipse,
for such tutorials and easy setup and really fast project I use NetBeans, and they are faster for that, I think. So I used it for this one.
No?
Okay.
Would you mind syncing over here?
Just try with this. Try with this cable.
How is your battery life on the T500?
But not so good. that's my whole laptop.
Yeah.
I had to change the battery even.
Mm-hmm. Because on this one, for me, it's like 2 hours and something, and then.
Depends on what I'm doing.
This one,
I
don't know.
I was saying, you do it.
Or
in charge,
so
okay.
But I received my new laptop already.
I have to make a stunning
evergreen
transition. And I have issues with the
On the new one. It's crazy. When randomly it doesn't recognize my user password and my enter key doesn't work.
Really?
And then I shut down. I open again, and I put my name. And
I mean, for me, it happened. They messed with the keyboard subsystem in Fedora Fidiki, and when you enter the locks cryptographic password, you know, I always had like a US keyboard, right? And then it swapped for something else, and I was unable to enter.
Oh, yeah.
But and then like I had one of the four key kernels, but now like
I have to set up the path and install other stuff
because I was having a lot of conferences and I cannot rely on the letter.
But the 10G is nice, it's now becoming stable because I think like it can be used as a new basis for a new rally now in time. So it's getting stable and
stable.
Mine, I had before X230, it was excellent.
Okay, so it's clear that Wi-Fi issue.
Yeah.
Because also the downloading of the zip file is like
1 hour or
exactly.
One
so
K.
Which kind of Java is executing?
The Wi-Fi is completely.
Sorry about the Wi-Fi.
It's more from this down. First
Didn't skip the continuation. Does the scaffold sort of face download something from internet?
Sorry?
Does the scaffold for the UI download something from the internet?
If you need the cable again, we can work it out. Gonna have a seat.
Sure. I gotta grab mine.
I don't think you. I'm not sure if you can take the chair.
Any reason to freeze the command line?
It's because it's not downloading for necessary jars. It's
It's because after every command is issued, Forge attempts to build the project. So it will display any warnings or any completion errors, any errors that might be found in the project are displayed after the command is issued. So probably at this point, Forge is trying to build your project. But since the Wi-Fi is not working that well, it might take a while for that to happen.
Can I help you?
The JPS setup command allows you
remove so you can have more space and more power.
But we haven't tested yet, to be honest.
What about the application setup deployment?
You mean the add-on, the AS setup add-on?
Yeah.
Oh, no. This was created by the community and they only created for the Wildfly and the JBoss EAP.
Uh-huh.
You don't have the Tommy. Unless it's possible to have one for Tommy if you extend the common base classes that the add-on provides. You could create an add-on for Tommy and then make available for the community. That's a homework.
Probably I can do that, but you know.
That's a raspberry chicken.
Yeah, it's worth the raspberry.
Is there some offline mode which you can use? Because
sorry.
It doesn't look like it. Like, can I say that I'm offline and should not try the container?
Oh, you can, if you set in your settings XML in Maven, you just put the offline tag.
Yeah, that's
your work.
I mean Maven settings.
Maven, yeah, in your settings XML.
Uh-huh.
There's a.
You can say some parameter to the Forge itself.
Don't really need nothing to go away.
Let me see.
Yeah, because I remember having it in 1.0, so probably 2.0.
I'll answer in a minute. All this.
I cannot even break it, I have to kill it.
Probably the bug. No, there isn't. No, that was a Forge one thing, I guess.
Yeah.
How's everything
going? I don't think it's doing anything. I'm still in that same jar
but
that I've been on for like 30 minutes.
Is it connected on the Wi-Fi instead?
No, it's not. Well, I can, yeah, we can.
Yeah, just to make sure.
Yeah, just let's take the wire less off. Where's the
open network preference?
Yeah.
Where's the network? Oh, over here.
It's on it.
Okay.
It's connected.
Cool. So let's do this. Let's stop this madness. And let's move this again, just to be sure. Let's restart it.
Yeah, this is what happened last time. I ended up force quitting because I was it just kind of.
Yes.
Close
where is
the say it will close when I will finish importing the project.
So I have me. Come on, I don't want you alive.
Now he's stuck.
Die.
Updating the error.
Okay. Yeah. There you go. Oh, sure. This is easy. Just quick fix. And yeah, ta-da!
Congratulations! All right, so right. Now disconnect. Let's see if I can go do something.
The cable should help.
Yeah. Okay, just have a seat over here.
The cable.
Here's your... Okay. There you go.
It's connected from Wi-Fi, just make sure. Probably you just should have to close JBDS and open again, right?
No, I have no idea. Should I? Just cancel it.
It's connected. Yeah, you can close. It's connected from the Wi-Fi. Open it again. Did it disconnect from Wi-Fi?
Yeah, no.
Just
wire. It's wired now.
Yeah.
Should it disconnect?
Yeah. So
just in case.
Just to force using the cable. Wow. I can hear your fan working.
All right. Cool. Forge is bundled already with CRUD.
The Forge 3.
Yeah, you don't have. You don't have to install. You might see here the Forge. What
console?
What? Just close it.
Mm-hmm.
And Control 4.
Yeah.
Forge starting. It should present the Forge console after that. Hopefully. Are you sure you're running on JDK 8? Ah,
yep.
Probably so, yeah. Otherwise.
Yep.
Yeah, there it is.
Ooh.
Okay, go to the window. Show view. And the other. And the Forge console. Yeah, this one.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, there it is.
Perfect.
No.
You need to wait for this. Is it downloading something?
No, it's doing nothing at the moment.
I think I'm set.
Probably try to create a project before anything else. Type project-new. You have to click over here,
yeah.
Sorry. Project. You can use autocomplete.
Something is... It's thinking,
it's
working. It's working somehow.
I can see by your ADD drive.
Yeah. Isn't this taking much or about building?
Excuse me.
This building thing is
probably it's downloading the dependencies.
Yeah, but it shouldn't block Forge. It's not. Try stop it and start it again.
Can you open the details, please?
Okay, you can now forge is run in running.
Yeah.
Try to type now. Tab. Yeah.
Yeah.
So project.
Project new.
New.
Slash. Dash dash. Name it. Name it. Name it. You can autocomplete. Choose CD. Yeah. CD bookstore. And yeah, and another option is called stack dash dash stack JavaEE 7.
Yeah.
You can use autocomplete if you want.
Mm-hmm.
It's all on uppercase.
Uh-huh. So it was on
yeah, 7.
7.
Yeah. And just press enter.
Everybody's waiting on me?
No.
No,
no. Wait, just how can you? Yeah.
Yeah, that's a lot of stuff to download.
I hope everyone can use to plug to do that for you.
Yeah? At least it works.
Yeah.
You can. If the internet doesn't come to you, you come to the
internet.
Yep. That is the end.
If you have time, yeah, I would suggest you to do like the Docker Lab to create virtual machines with Nexus.
With Nexus, that is.
Oh,
yeah.
That is great. Into the good world.
But that would take more bandwidth that we don't have.
Good. Now you preload.
Yep, you're good.
Yep.
You're set. You should see a CD bookstore over here.
Yeah.
I'll show you what I did. It's a preloaded Docker. It's a preloaded Nexus with everything, every dependencies.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Installed.
Thank you.
All right. You're welcome.
Thank you.
So this is something that is new from the Forge 3 compared to the Forge 2. If you use it to Forge 2, you will notice that there is one field missing in the screen. That is the JP version. When we created a project, the CD Bookstore, we explicitly told that we wanted to use the Java 7 stack. That is enough for Forge to understand that whenever you set up a project like a technology like JPA or Servlet or EGB, you don't need to specify the version anymore. So that's why you don't see the JPA version in here. If you choose no stack, then the JPA version will be present because Forge has no way to know which Java version are you working on.
How are you doing the version alignment? For example, version of Hibernate in Wildfly 10 will be different from Wildfly 10.01 or whatever?
Actually, this is handled by the... We have some extension points in the JPA plugin with a specific detection for the container and the providers. Like, let me see here.
Whenever
suppose that if I would like to use some Hibernate specific features, I have to
add
a dependency in Hibernate,
sure.
So I don't need
exactly.
a version,
mm-hmm.
which is to depend on the server which I'm going to deploy.
Right.
So how will you find out?
Right now, you don't have the only information that Forge records is on the persistence XML. You can't figure out what is the container that is being targeted to just by looking at the persistence XML. So right now we don't store Forge has no way of knowing what is the container that you're willing to use at the moment, unless we develop an add-on for this.
So am I able to specify the bomb which I want to use, or I Forge way, call it, or do I have to do it manually?
Which one are you talking about?
If I would like to use bomb, bill of materials, which
mm-hmm.
will tell me the versions of dependencies.
Okay.
So I have to manually enter it into my POM and...
If you want to depend on Forge dependencies? Or what?
No, on...
On a specific container?
No, yeah, exactly.
Like a wildfly bomb or something
yeah,
like that?
Yeah.
That's not... That's usually not what you do in a JavaEE project. I don't think bomb is the solution in here.
Maybe because the bomb managed the version, and so in this case he didn't need to specify the version of Hibernate dependence. He just mentions the group ID and the artifact ID, and the bomb will resolve the proper version.
All right, I see. I understand. All right. Yeah, that could be a nice enhancement. But anyway, we need to store that somewhere. I don't think storing inside the project would be...
You'll be the solution.
Yeah, maybe, I don't know. We need to think a bit about it. The fact is that Forge is non-intrusive. Like, your project doesn't have anything bound to Forge. Generated project. So we try to keep that as non-intrusive as possible. But...
That means that the Forge project doesn't use any bomb at this moment,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
So,
well, exactly.
So this project is more JavaEE compliant.
Yeah.
So it can be deployed on any application server.
Correct.
That's why it doesn't use a
specific
bomb.
Correct. Yeah. Exactly.
But if you can
extend from. We have extension points that will allow you to do that.
And even if you add it manually to the POM XML, Forge won't break because of that.
Yeah, exactly.
So, George, this is what I was proposing.
The Nexus.
Yeah, it's a pre-filled Nexus.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
As you can see. Tem aqui o coisa e eu leio o data volume.
Eu fico com o cabo ligado para baixar os...
É. Você vê que aqui, nesse, o que que eu tenho nesse aqui no instrutor? Eu tenho um servidor Git, um HTTP server, um Nexus.
Legal.
Essa postgres aqui é só por causa do Git. Uma interface gráfica para ele. E o registro do Docker.
Uhum.
Cada um rodando uma porta.
Uhum.
É, só dou um Docker Compose. Abre aqui e ele já sobe
legal.
A porra toda.
Vou fazer isso no próximo.
É.
Só que daí o problema é o IU, né?
É, eu já tive problema de não aguentar. Por exemplo.
Se colocar num OpenShift não vai ter espaço suficiente. Colocar num servidor remoto.
É, eu sei que realmente não aguento.
XHTML file generated when I edit the description title and so on for the group
mm-hmm.
entity. So is there any easy way how to recreate those XHTML files and so on?
now the old generation stuff is backed by a library called Meta Widget. Widget.
Yeah, it's in that library, but
yeah. So that this library is what reads the entities and generates the GSF pages. But right now, if you want to customize this output, you have to extend, you have to implement your own scaffold provider. I think that would be
it.
I think it would be the easiest
solution.
Of course, something, if it's something simple, like adding a description, we could add in the core and go with the next.
Not just the situation where I'm thinking about business.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
And you have a lot of changes. And
Right. Yeah. So that would be the best solution. Create your own scaffold provider, and then you can tell Forge to generate the artifacts that you want, the pages that you want, and the layout that you want, using a free marker style template.
And what about some programmer made changes in the HTMLs, so that is there any way how to deal with those? You know, he wanted to add some, I don't know, class style or something like that, just to put it.
Yeah, probably going for the programming.
You mean
developers do this all the time. They have generated or created by whatever library, HTML markup. They wanted to, the customer wants this field to be blue and not red mark.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever he wants. So, developer goes to the HTML page, facelet or remark, template, doesn't matter. Or changes that blue style for the red one, and customer is full.
Whenever you regenerate using the scaffold, you pick up these new changes, you mean?
Yeah, and I don't want to do it manually, is there any merged algorithm
No.
It is or something like that?
No, that's a very specific situation. I think this is out of scope of Forge, to be honest.
Maybe it is, but...
But you could create a command to apply those changes. I think that would be the solution.
And is there any real business application done to JBoss Forge?
Sorry?
Whether there is some really big application that has been done by JBoss Forge. Do you know some? Anyone?
Well, we have the Ticket Monster. That is the application that we use throughout the whole JBoss.
Thank you guys.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you
for joining.
Bye. But do you know of any big project using Forge for development or any factory?
It seems to be nice for some rapid prototyping.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the scaffold that bundles with Forge is exactly that. It's for, as you can see, the generated scaffold doesn't follow like the layer, several layers with DAOs and managers and all this stuff. So it's basically a simple prototype for you to start with.
Yeah.
So
it's good for prototyping, but not only that, because the code, the structure which is generated, you can use that as a base for your real project then.
Right. Yeah.
You don't have to rework it.
Yeah, I understand it, but that's just one time for setup the project that I have to manage it manually, as I'm used to do. And does it have any advantages for me in that case?
especially when I have to write add-ons for using different templates and for deploying it on Tomi and so on. And maybe I'm not the right user, but I do prototyping a lot and I use Java for that. And very often use J2EE stack. So maybe. And if I want to do just one time project, I will use for that an IDE wizard that can do that, and that all of current IDEs have wildfly integration, JBoss integration. And so on. So what? It's hard to find an advantage of JBoss Forge for me.
George, what's how can
this be challenged?
Forge hold.
I use a lot of the Angular. Even if I will change it completely, but all the boring Angular stuff for me that I could do myself, that
it's
taking a morning, just a few seconds. It's really for a kickoff that my
Days
for Forge is really for a kickoff to start a new project.
The real advantage comes when you automate your needs, like you have a specific need that Forge doesn't suit you. You can always write an add-on for it. You can use the Forge APIs. We have a roster with a library for parsing Java classes that can understand the class structure and allows you to, add annotations to a method or create new methods using a simple and fluent API. So Forge provides all these libraries. You have all the tools needed to do your work. You just need to figure out what we want to do. This is what we offer right now. And of course, Forge provides several extension points that...
What was the main motivation, the motivation why you have started to develop JBoss Forge?
Developer productivity and fun.
Yeah. In fact, it all started with Forge theme, right?
With theme.
Yeah.
Theme. Have you heard of JBoss theme?
Yeah. I have never used it. I just know a few information.
JBoss theme is a framework that allows you to create a JSF 1.2 application.
Yeah. Yeah.
And at the time, there was a generator called ScenGen that it would pick the entities and generate, scaffold the necessary pages to run the scene application. So then it came scene 3, and then the whole idea of instead of being bound to a specific framework, Forge showed up and provided a way to create Java, pure Java E6 apps. So we try to follow this. We want to make the application that is developed with Forge is totally JavaEE compliant, and there are no specific libraries bound to it. That's why we generate so many codes with so many beans and without the layers and all this stuff. Of course, there are some good practice that we could have been following, like having an abstract base class for all the common methods and all this stuff, but
one thing that I like from Forge is, suppose that you want to start an application using JPA and Angular in the front end and using AGB. Sometimes you need to have a maven archetype for that.
Mm-hmm.
But so suppose that you want JPA with JSF, another archetype. JPA with a Killian test and whatever, another archetype. With Forge, you can customize the creation of a project without depending on the archetype, because you just go adding and add another feature and add another feature and add another feature, and you have the whole project without depending on a specific archetype that provides everything that you need. So that's the thing that I really like. And that was the idea that, as George said, started with C, because C needed used JPA, could use or not AGB, use it JSF, use it rich faces. So C then created everything for you to start with a C project. And then when C3 came, people start to use Forge on that time to set up for a scene project. But then the developers realized that instead of generating projects only for scene, it could be used to generate all kinds of Java projects with Forge 1. Then
thank you.
And then people realized that with Forge 2 that it doesn't need to be just on console. It could be plugged to NetBeans, it could be plugged as an extension for IntelliJ, for Eclipse.
The main feature that Forge provides is the independence of IDEs. If you write a command for using Forge APIs, you can make sure that it will run in Eclipse, IntelliJ, or NetBeans without changing a single line of code.
Actually, we have something, we have a framework in our company that uses specific DSL.
Mm-hmm.
And do something, does something quite similar, like this JBoss Forge. It takes this DSL, generates.
It's a code generator.
So, yeah, it uses standard Eclipse AMF.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, yeah.
Yeah,
we start to use that, and maybe that can be the situation, because but we also generate from that JP entities,
mm-hmm.
as we want to have all those hash codes and
mm-hmm.
and serial
mm-hmm.
IDs, and I saw that there is a version, so that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, deep clone methods and so on and so on. So this is why that helps developers
mm-hmm.
to start rapidly. They do a lot of manual work, of course, but sometimes they want to regenerate it again. And in that situation, we had to deal with the changes in, you know, because we realized that there is a bug in deep clone method, whatever, and we have, I don't know, in this project, 500-600 of entities. What want to change it at once?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, without and keeping the whole.
Because. There has to be someone who will think about it, who will do it, who will check that it's done on all those entities. So in such situation, we again use this generator. It checks the original one, the new one,
mm-hmm.
make diff, and checks some, you know, our outtake that it's...
you could have a Forge command.
Hand change. Yeah, and in such situation, it may match that changes or whatever.
It's synchronizing and dealing with conflicts. Yeah, it's pretty complex.
Yeah.
You have some libraries for that.
Yeah.
We started the synchronization framework, as I will do.
Okay.
More. But yeah, other options should be an annotation. For instance, unmetas do not overwrite or something like that.
Yeah.
You could mark your part of code that you want to keep, and when you regenerate it again, to keep that methods.
Yeah, one thing that is nice to mention is that
the Forge API provides some facilities. For example, if you want to know what are the entities in your code, what are the classes that has the that have the entity annotation, you can you have a method in Forge that returns that. So it's you can use the Forge API for that, for browsing the project and checking what are the technologies that are installed on it, the dependencies. You want to install a new Maven dependency, Forge has the APIs to use a fluent API and just adds the dependency to your own XML and whatever. Whatever you need to do with your project, change the, create new classes, change your own XML. You want to use Gradle, it understands the Gradle new descriptor, anyway.
But what you said, that it's agnostic from any IDE, though you write your add-in and it works everywhere.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome. But I don't know if you have ever done Eclipse Spring development.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I've done some.
It's pretty hard.
Did you enjoy it?
I've been doing that for some years, and
it's horrible.
It's horrible.
Painful.
And with when I did my first add-in, was just awesome because it's pretty, the API is pretty clear, and then you install the header and you have the UI for free.
Exactly.
So
and it works.
You have really specific
keywords
that you identify
keywords.
Manual work that your work is due over and over, and you would like to have a Eclipse plugin or an admin.
And the thing is, it's that it will. The
or
command that
means or intelligent.
Yeah.
Without changing line of code. That's fantastic.
Yeah, you got a CLI,
and there's web as well.
And the web
and show it.
That's pretty new on the edge, huh?
Yeah. That's cutting edge technology.
So you can host the Forge as a service.
Yeah, that's
so
that's what we're doing for the
in
future
fact,
versions.
Using it.
Yes, so basically you can go online and say I want to create a new project and Forge Online will create it for you. And we still have to do something, you can provide a Git repo, that should be nice. Because
oh, that's what's private
repo.
Fabricate does that.
Oh,
you can create a project and automatically goes to GitHub, publishes on GitHub, and then you can deploy to an open shift.
Yeah,
and
pick up by Jenkins and build
it. Wow, the whole gang. Is this yours?
Yes, mine is closed.
Okay.
I don't
sure
think
what's
so.
Mine. Anyway. Yeah. Oh, there's a video. I recorded a video. Oh.
The cable, yeah.
Let me show you a video of Forge as a service.
Well, I'm
being
right now.
I also like the West endpoint generation. That is really
oh, yeah, that's really useful.
Because that is typically boring code you have to type yourself. And
no, you will generate on time, just use the IDE for that.
Okay, I don't know the IDE, but.
For Eclipse, also in NetBinder, there's funding, and I think that IDEA has the same functionality.
Probably, yeah.
As they are reading all of those automatism. So, yeah, I think that I just once, maybe once I wrote REST API for my own, all the time I'm using IDEs for that. I'm too lazy to
let me be too lazy.
Even to remember all those things.
Exactly. You don't need to remember all the things, but tools can do that for you.
Yes, this is it. This is the web version of JBoss Forge. It's still a prototype, but we're getting there. So you can type the project and choose the project type. And the next is a neighbor or not. Yeah. Yeah, so This is running my machine, so all the commands that Forge has, it's can be shown. And choose the database and setting up JPA. So yeah, that's the persistence generated. That's it.
And also creating your own scaffold provider. That's also for which you have very specific.
Can I take that one?
It's a bit experimental, but the Angular scaffolder, and I change it so it's creating Cordova. Cordova is to make just a web app.
Is it downloading stuff?
Yeah, I was trying to see if I did everything and I was trying to deploy, but I had to do the wildfly add-ons and that is, I don't know where now.
Okay, instead install the swarm add-on, I think it would be better.
I'm in the middle of this command.
I have to stop it here.
Okay.
Oh, you have to start again. Sorry.
So, what's the story with the starting every time? Like, is
it's because Forge has its own runtime. Every time you start Forge has to start Furnace and the add-ons and all the stuff, all the plugins.
Okay.
So it takes a bit of time. That's why it has the starting.
Okay, so you want me to do...
Oh, the swarm. Add-on. Install from git. Type outcome.
From git.
Yeah. Whatever. Yeah. Wow. Oh, that's a Mac OS issue. From
Oops.
That works.
Yeah.
Yeah, just the URL changes a bit.
Okay.
Is that? Oh my goodness.
That's really bad. This earlier it was kind of doing this like type it out, but now this is doing a flashy thing that's really obnoxious.
Psychedelic stuff.
Yeah. All right. So.
Oh, okay. So. Yeah.
Good luck with that.
Yo. Oh, Forge. Wild.
If you want to learn, that's what I told people. If they would, when I scaffold the Angular app, I said, if you don't know Angular,
I'm doing this one just because it's smaller.
Start to
much smaller.
Scaffold a really simple app with the CRUD operation, and the code is pretty clean with the Angular app, and you can learn. You can just by browsing the code, you can.
But don't be intimidated by the size. I think it will download some pretty big stuff after it. Because it, as it uses Wildfly, I think it will download some Wildfly artifacts, and that would be pretty big.
That's good. This is going way better than the last attempt. Plugged in.
Is it over?
No.
20 minutes? All right. Okay, so everybody's completed the lab.
I have questions.
All right.
At least I have a functional application deployed on Wildfly. That's enough.
Perfect. Perfect. Yeah. Okay. I encourage you to try Forge and try to write your own add-on plugins and. Give us your feedback. That will be of great value. And I don't know. we need to. Yeah. Do you want the Raspberry Pi?
I went to USA this summer or the last summer, and they taught a strange thing to me because my sister lives here for a couple of years now, and. They taught when you meet Czech guy, they are really strange when you ask them whether they want something,
okay.
They won't tell you, yes, I want it, even if they want it. And they often offer you something.
That's okay, we're not American, we're from Brazil.
what they don't want to give you, but they still offer it to you.
Sure.
Do you want my lunch, whatever?
All right.
But that's my lunch, I don't want to give you my lunch.
As an American, I wouldn't know what to do with that.
Really,
you'll never take a lunch from an American.
Become red.
I'm not red.
Yeah.
So if you are
maybe
asking,
it's the cold.
Yes, I want.
Okay. Oh, there you go. You won.
Good job.
There you go. Congratulations. You're the winner.
Yay! Yay. Yay. I didn't dub anything. Yeah, that's
it's
pretty cool.
It's really cool. Really cool.
You can do a lot of different things.
Do you like games?
Yeah, retro time.
Retro
time. All the old. I played with my son. I just connected to the TV and I retro time, and you can play all the old consoles games.
Atari, Mega Drive,
yeah,
Super Nintendo.
30 years ago.
Yeah.
Go try to control a door in your house or something using it.
Yeah, actually, I have. intelligent house,
yeah.
So it's done already. I use this some PLC for that, so it's as for the, you know, you don't want to come home to this evening and notify that your SD card in your small PC has gone and you are not able to, I don't know, switch on the lights, for example. You don't want to be in such situation.
You can run wildfire.
No, you can run wildfire. Yeah,
you distribute things. So
it's not really well.
There is a blog post about
it.
Yeah.
It's because when you install, there's an SD card that you put in Raspberry Pi. In this SD card, you can install everything you want. You can run a Fedora, you can run a...
Yeah, but still it's an ARM.
Yeah.
So it shouldn't be so fast to run JavaStack with for wildfire,
wow.
I think.
What
yeah,
I can tell,
I
can tell you is the fact that the person who managed to do it was Mark Leo. So, might work. And that's a USB 2, right?
It has an HDMI output,
that's gonna
suck, so you can put
have
to in
pull
television.
On smooth download.
It's fantastic.
It's very funny. Yeah.
It's really you really enjoy it.
Or even for
there's
kids.
There's no way to know
for
how
kids,
long you have to go.
Like,
yeah.
You can
it's
buy
just like
some,
doing a bunch of stuff, but there's
wires,
no like
sensors,
you have 25 more things to get or anything like
oh,
that.
In fact, they
Arduino?
Quench
yeah.
the files.
Yeah.
It, no,
yeah,
no,
it's
this.
That's
a,
not all of them. That's
yeah.
just the stuff.
It's really
I know.
Awesome.
Now I got you.
So I don't know how many more
Maven
things it wants to pull.
For that central house system, but it has 4H.
I don't know how you do that
five,
in command line though when you're doing scrolling.
You are LT.
Yeah,
okay.
Just like
a
yum terminal where you can see how many files.
Factory system.
I mean, I guess maybe you could do something like every once in a while it does.
And you can
update which files it's downloading. I guess every once in a while you could just insert
in
the middle of this your overall
so
status.
You can do it, but
that might be nice.
I will not work next month.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because
oh,
in a
one
traditional
one
terminal,
one
it won't scroll, it will just keep moving. But
yeah, unless it scrolls, so it's,
but
you'd have to keep popping it in every.
Yeah, so you can use just.
See, it does that every once in a while where it tells you what it's still working on. So
you
just alongside that, give an overall one.
Yeah.
It's a keyboard, the mouse, and the
Wi-Fi.
I have the feeling that it's just missed these two files.
And
updated.
I don't think
sensors.
So.
And he brought some nice.
Maybe you're right, but I think it's
going to
start something else when it's done with those two.
Once the temperature go went high, we got a push message.
Oh, yeah.
I'm plugged in too. It's
super
exciting. Yeah, it was supposed to be faster.
Except
yeah.
It was a earthquake detector with Arduino. Also
oops.
And when it was detected, it was.
Is it worth sending?
It's
yeah.
Slow.
And he was doing the demo in
the world. To download the world.
It was connected to my phone. And in the middle
I even backups the internet.
And I sip it every once in a while and inserted a line saying where you are and the overall things that you need to download. I have no idea if these two are the last things or if it's
going to
kick off something else again.
Maven is back up in the internet.
Don't go there.
No.
Because I've been two days ago. I've been to Arduino session in FIT, at Maastricht University here.
Okay.
And that measuring temperatures hello world in Arduino world. So everyone who started with.
Let's see.
Yeah.
Oh, we're not even really close because the other one still has another 1,000 to go.
All right.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right, so
you still have this.
Do you want Sparks?
Sparks?
You won't say you were yet.
Yeah. Yeah.
I
think that's true. That's really true, that situation.
Okay.
Because I met it all the time.
Yeah.
Rabbit.
Yeah, I get several, but I don't roll anymore.
You get too much.
Let me give
you
our new.
Yeah, maybe I can give one.
Thank you.
But I don't.
You have a little short.
Mind
oh, yeah. But my co-speaker yesterday was attacked because the scars are exact color of his enemy football club. So he said, no way!
Almost. See what happens.
And another file. No.
Nope.
Downloaded.
But still has other stuff to do.
All right. Thanks for attending the talk. I appreciate. Sorry for the Wi-Fi, but
you can't control that.
I promise that Forge works beautifully with the nice Wi-Fi and it's downloading the necessary dependencies.
That's not the Forge fault because it's
downloading
from Maven Central, so...
Yeah, let's blame Maven.
Next time we'll bring the internet.
That's always a good answer.
Yeah, next time we'll bring a Nexus server.
You remember what happened in that...
You should burn it.
See, now it's hard, but downloading a bunch of other shit.
I think
you
have
from another...
Can you do a presentation on this?
Sure,
questions?
Of course.
Free slides.
Loose drive.
So one thing there is in
special stickers for
speed.
Oh, I have it.
All right. I got to pull the plug. I'm supposed to meet somebody here.
Okay.
Now.
Yeah, I should do that too.
Your friend.
With Grant.
Rafael, do you want? Do you have?
Yeah, I have it here on my laptop.
Nice.
Yeah, stop. All right.
Yeah.
Try again later.
Anyway, if you need anything, Georgie will help.
Yeah,
I'll be happy to.
Yeah, I think
we
need. Let me unplug.
Also, thank you for your.
Oh, thank you.
Have a nice rest of your
day. Okay, I appreciate. Thank you.
Thank you, you too, for your help.
Plus 14.
See you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Right.
Yeah.
Now I need to lunch. I need to eat some.
Now I need to eat.
And
I believe
you
made all fast.
Well,
I think the
better
piece. If it keeps a better, this thing.
But we are good, but it's more reliable than the first desk. Not so much. You got the bearers? No? What's the bearers?
I'm west.
PHP
7.0.
Ah, there's
go. Ah, there's go. Yeah. Yeah, 13. Потом же цикл на конце там кончит, да? Сюда типа.
Ну. Так где?
Потом же цикл.
Да, вот тут это берёшь.
Угу. Что так пойдёт отсюда? Можно. Это куда для?
Давай.
Я этот.
Ну, сейчас.
Я понял, что там.
Já jsem se neměl zpátky slovy, že jo,
aha, ale slovy tak prostě sám.
To co zase není.
Tu já věc není. Jinak musíš to hýklat.
Ale ne, už to hýkneš.
Tak stará.
A ne, tak ale ty já tam mám ze skriptování disku. To by zase nedal přesně.
A nemá na to vybavení, že? Má to dobře vybavené. Fajn.
Tak to tu máš v rámce?
Tak to uděláte.
Aha, ale kdybych to vyšlo, tak...
Tak se to vyšlo.
Aha, no.
All right, thank you.
Yeah, thank you too. Thank you.
See you guys.
Any of those?
Yeah.
Should we get some Marcel? Yeah, should we do it now? Huh? Should we do it now? I'll show you how to do it. Hodím. Anuragovi vezmu tu šálu, kterou jsem dostal.
Tady máš.
Yep, já vím. Hej.
Hej. Hej.
Yep.
You are the next speaker?
Yes.
Okay, yeah. Excellent. For the better of training, right? For the better.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, excellent. Let me just clean the place for you.
Coming with a question.
Okay.
That are active, you want to reward them somehow, yeah?
Okay.
So feel free to use them.
Okay.
Like for you. Also,
I have some water for you.
So you can use refresh yours.
Does the HDMI work or should I
use? It should. Try it,
okay.
Please. We haven't tried, but it should be working. I'm not sure. If not, it should be possible.
Oh, as I mentioned, we should cast it. Martin, how much
is it? 3-4 hours.
I didn't know.
I didn't know. I didn't know. I didn't know. I didn't know. I didn't know. Here is your speaker sticker. On this people got this, and then please upload your presentation in this flash disk if you can for us.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it doesn't, I don't think it's working, but it should be
okay.
Possible to set it on this screen. Just the mechanics to be done.
We are not allowed to do that, we have to call it guy from university.
Jo, budeme si vybrat s VGAčkem a HDMIčkem.
Ne, it's not working out bad.
No, it's here, like, you
so
can...
Just, yo. Yeah, I know that
is the beamer switched on, or...?
Huh? I believe it should be switched
okay, then.
Here, but...
So you don't have VGA, right?
Yeah, I will call the guy.
I have VGA also, so... But so if HDMI works, I don't...
Well, the thing is that we have to call the guy from the university to reconfigure the, to the box, you know, so we can switch between VGA and HDMI.
Not necessary, I think I will try this one then.
Yeah, this one.
Just this tight. You can call it anyway.
Will you need the USB drives?
There are some files, but yesterday, because it was late, I prepared something else. I have also some sticks which will, I will pass around.
Okay. So if you need them, you
so
still
those
need
files
them?
Are actually outdated, right? On our drives?
Not really, I have some additional files for some practicing.
And
stuff.
Some USB sticks. You can replicate it if you want in the meanwhile.
Yes.
At least a few of them.
Yeah, yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah. Good.
And shall we introduce you shortly, briefly?
Yeah.
Or your name, your presentation name, and some brief bio or something.
Yeah,
may I just ask you for your name so I will pronounce it correctly? Yeah, I know the name.
It's Stefan Dürr.
Stefan Dürr.
Yeah.
Okay, I will try my best.
Okay, no problem.